friends, it's Gwen and I'm back with another scrapbooking process video. Today's share is part of the Documenting December YouTube hop that's happening right now. I'll leave some details in the description box below if you don't know what that's all about, because this is my third share for the hop. So yeah, check that out below. I am using today Pinkfresh Studio Holiday Vibes collection. So this one is from 2018, I believe. And I actually happened to stumble across this, which was a layout that I started last year and obviously forgot all about. And it was just when I was going through that stash that I went, oh, I started something with that one. So today's share is actually going to be two for one. You'll see me create the layout that I'm about to start now, as well as finish off that other page. Okay, so for this page, I am going to be using the cut file right there called Jingle Bells. I had cut it quite large, so to sort of give myself a little bit more space on my layout, I decided to push it over to the side of the page ever so slightly, and it just meant trimming off a little bit of the edge there on the left. So I am going to add it here flat to the background, and that's because I will want to add my stitching around the border there, so I wouldn't be able to do that if I'd popped it up on foam. So this is the plan on the design of the page. I do actually scooch the photo over a little bit more to the right, but it will be on the bottom half of the page and then the bell is going to be on the top part of the page. And at this point, I'm not really sure where I'm going. I'm really just going through the embellishments. They're familiar to me because I had made at least one other page, I think maybe two, prior to this one, just recently with this collection. So yeah, the elements were familiar to me, but I really didn't have a clear idea about, you know, whether I wanted two embellishment clusters, whether there would be, you know, one on the left, one on the right. I kind of did think that I needed something substantial on the right there, because that was sort of the only empty space on my page. I had gone to the trouble of backing that cut file, which did take a little while. So obviously I don't want to cover up a lot of the, you know, a lot of that side. And yeah, I'm just thinking about how the eye will travel across the page, what my color scheme's going to be, trying to exclude some things so that I don't have so many choices to make, and yeah, just getting a feel for where this page is going to be going. And I do decide to keep it simple. So the color scheme I'm going with is that deep green that's on my border there, the bright reddy orange, and touches of the baby blue, just to soften it, and to, like, that green and that orange or red is quite a traditional color scheme. So I actually liked adding the blue because I felt like it made it a little bit more modern. So yeah, so just went through everything and excluded anything that didn't fit that color scheme. So that was helpful to eliminate some items. And just started the audition process. Now, the other thing that I was quite aware of at this point was the shapes in the cut file being very circular or like flowy. This cut file is not a geometric one in any way, shape or form. So there's lots of, like, the bells are circles and curves, the bow's very flowy. So because of that, I was very aware that I couldn't use a lot of rectangular or block style elements in my embellishments. I needed to, you know, pick up on some circles and, yeah, like, just make sure that nothing was too blocky with my positioning and with the design of the page. I've also decided at this point that the direction that the eye is going to flow around the page will be top left down towards the photo, bottom right. So I will end up with a pretty large cluster above the bow there, in that space in the background above the bow. The main cluster is going to be on the right of the photo there, with that little tab that says filled with Christmas spirit, and then the present on top. And then we're going to have for our triangle, what is it, rule of three? No, visual triangle. We'll have a smaller embellishment cluster on the left there. But that one's just going to be a couple of little pieces to balance everything out. Oh, yes. And I did really struggle, and I have no idea why, choosing a round embellishment for the center of the bow there. I auditioned so many pieces for that. Yeah, it's crazy. I don't know why certain parts of a page can really trip me up. So some parts just come together really easily and the cluster flows and yeah, it's like I'm not even thinking. And then sometimes it can be the smallest little thing like, oh, what do I put in the center of the bow that really gets me? And I literally auditioned maybe 20 different things and ended up with a die cut circle element that was ever so slightly larger than that star, I guess it's a star, orange enamel circle thing. And I just layered them on top. The die cut piece underneath is baby blue, is that pretty blue. So it was a really nice touch to add in between the layers. But yeah, I don't know what that is. Does that happen to you too? It's so frustrating that something that's so simple like that can really, hold up the creating process. Maybe it's just me. Please don't tell me it's just me. Maybe it's me just overanalyzing and it's that perfectionism that comes back. That's like, no, I don't need the first or the second or the third thing I try. I need the perfect, you know, embellishment to go in that spot. Anyway, it all comes together in the end, and I guess I'm lucky that this is not a race. Anyway, things are getting serious. I have my glue out and I am locking some things into position. Loving how this is coming together. Trying to have a real mix of embellishments in each of the clusters. So every out of the three clusters, they've all got, you know, a little piece of chipboard or a puffy sticker, so something dimensional. They all have a die cut and then something round, so those little wooden buttons or the enamel. I want to call them enamel dots, but then they're not like the little tiny enamel dots that you'd use at the end. I wonder what they call them. I'll have to have a look at the packaging. They're like enamel circle doodads. Epoxy stickers. Yes, I did just have to go and look that up, but that's what they're called, epoxy stickers. So at this point, I'm really happy with the cluster on the right and it's all locked in. And I just then go and work a little bit more on the cluster on the left. I do add in the wooden elements. I really love these. The wood is like the super soft color. And yeah, it actually pulls a little bit from the colors in my photo. And yeah, they're really dimensional too. So they're a really nice thing to add interest and dimension to the page. So yeah, and they just round out clusters really nicely. Yeah, and see up the top there, I have also added in a few little more elements up there just to fill in that empty space above the bow. And they just sit, they sit really nicely up there and they're not covering up too much of the cut file. So as always, I do take a little bit of time and care, just making sure that the elements in the cluster are where I want them to be. So see, I moved the bird here and that was because there was sort of a little space in between that rectangular element and the bow and it looked a bit weird. You don't want sort of like empty space gaps. So I just squidged him over a little bit. I'm also adding in this die cut. I want to call them lights. Yeah, they're lights. There's another piece just like it down on the bottom right there. So it's nice to have it positioned up the top left because that also kind of gives your eye a little hint as to where it needs to move next. It ties the page together as well. So if you have a couple of elements that are the same, it's a really good idea to put them on the page and have one be in one embellishment cluster and the other be in another embellishment cluster. Just helps pull everything together. And it's done. So I'm gonna hold up, I'll add my stitching later. But yeah, here are the details, and we'll get on with the next page. So I did actually, I don't know where it went. Some of the footage has gone into where all the, I don't know, random YouTube footage goes. I can't find it. But remember, most of this page was done anyway. So I had already backed my cut file, and I'm using a background pattern paper that had all of those star, sort of snowy star shaped elements running down the left-hand edge. So all I've really done is add my photo on the left, and I've backed that in that same baby blue. So for this one, it's more white, the bright orange, and a baby blue color scheme. I do add in a couple of touches of the dark green, so just to make it pop a little bit, and you know, they were there, use them up. I did also go off screen and stitch, am I stitching around the photo there? And I will do that around the layer edge as well. If you would like to me to sort of have a little chat to you about my stitching and the thread I use, and maybe show you a few things with that, let me know below. I'm not sure whether people would want to see that. So yeah, let me know if that's something you might be interested in, and I can make that video. Yeah, so you can see the design and the lines for this one are really dictated by that background pattern paper. So because it had all of those embellishments running along the left-hand edge there, top to bottom, that's kind of where I've just put all of the embellishments that I'm adding. So, and then I have my nice big title to the right, photo next to it, and the page was done. So as I finish up the page here, I will remind you that there are some details in the description box below. I've listed all the girls who are joining in with the Documenting December YouTube Hop that's happening right now. So there is a share for every single day between the 1st and the 25th of December. So all those details are below. I'll leave links to both of the cut files I've used on both these pages. And if you're not already on my email list, there's a link there for you to join, and I send free digital cut files to all the ladies on that list at least twice a month. So yeah, so come join us over there. And yeah, as always, I will hold this one up as it's finished. And there are a stack of close-up images and still images for both layouts coming up at the end of this video. Thanks so much for spending some of your creative time with me. I so appreciate it. If you haven't already and you enjoy my videos and you'd like to see more, please subscribe. And yeah, I will see you in the next video. Bye!